Honorable Speaker, we listened to my friend Honorable Vijayadas Rajapaksa, the learned President's Council, and a controversial minister in this illegal government. I must put certain things in the correct perspective, though I am not at cross purposes with his, with the purpose with which he made that speech. But then certain matters had to be put in the correct perspective to clear the doubts that might arise in the minds of the general public of this country. Firstly, Mr. Speaker, he being a leading lawyer in the country, a long-time legislator in this house, knows that the concept of separation of powers and the way in which the three important institutions of state, namely the executive, the parliament, and the judiciary, have their own competencies. The need to have a careful balance between the competencies of all these three institutions is the paramount objective of all law-abiding citizens. The office bearers of these institutions, those who hold office, have to be mindful of the fact that each don't trespass on the competency of the other. If that doesn't happen, none of these problems could have arisen. So what had happened is because, little realizing that the 19th Amendment was meant to curtail the powers of the executive president in a certain manner, not realizing the fact that the executive president, I also in the meantime put in issue the matter that arose out of Honorable Anuradhisanayake's contention of Honorable Ranil Wickremesinghe occupying temple trees. We say the decision by the president to remove Honorable Ranil Wickremesinghe is ab initio void. And that matter is now before the Supreme Court through another petition that has been filed and is to be supported soon. Therefore, we cannot come to the conclusion that Honorable Ranil Wickremesinghe is illegally occupying temple trees. He has been one who had always respected the verdict of the people and have very honorably left the temple trees when the verdict of the people were otherwise. Here, when the executive president has unlawfully and unconstitutionally removed the prime minister, it is his contention and is our contention that he can remain there as a legal occupant unless otherwise the court holds otherwise. And I would dare say, now we would even be willing to replenish all the damages or whatever cost that might incur out of wrongful occupation of the temple trees if the courts hold otherwise. So, Mr. Speaker, now on the issue of one institution of state trespassing on the competency of the other, today we are in a very grave situation. This has to be rectified. I fully understand the purpose underlying the statement by the Honorable Vijayadas Rajapaksa. We appreciate that. It is up to you, Mr. Speaker, whether to consider such a reconciliation and bring to conclusion this unnecessary confrontation. You are not the first speaker was had to face such a difficulty. There had been several of your predecessors had to face similar problems, particularly after the enactment of the 78th Constitution. We have had several instances where this House and the executive was at each other's throat, not knowing whose competency you are trampling upon. Therefore, We can always reconcile these differences, but the facts as to whether who unconstitutionally abused the powers that were sought to be conferred on them is a matter that we had to seek clarification from the judiciary. There is no other place than Supreme Court of this country for us to go to seek interpretation of the Constitution. So we have had to seek the intervention of the Supreme Court, since in the long list of constitutional violations, His Excellency the President sought to dissolve Parliament. And that resolution had to, since we consider it once again an ab initio void matter, we have challenged it in court, and we had no other alternative. Therefore, that is not a matter for judicial purview of the House. Of course, courts exercise judicial power through Parliament, but that doesn't mean that we can just fold our arms and wait when the executive takes a decision to dissolve Parliament, totally unlawfully and unconstitutionally. Therefore, our resort to judicial remedy was totally justified in those circumstances. And quite apart from that, we are willing to consider, if there is a move to reconcile the differences, we can always try and sort it out between, since you are the custodian of our rights, you are fully within our fully within your rights to negotiate and bring this to a acceptable solution. Since the severe impact of the economy on the economy, and there is no government for the last 30 days in this country, there had been an illegal government put in place, and the perpetrated government does not have the guts to face the people, and they are in the pretext of boycotting this house, they are turning their backs on the people of this country. So it is important. I consider Honorable Mahinda Rajapaksa also as a great Democrat, but the last 30 days, he himself knows through his own conscience what he is doing is wrong. And therefore, and these two people, Honorable Ranil Wickremesinghe and Honorable Mahinda Rajapaksa, had been long-standing members of this August Assembly since the 70s. Who came first and who came last is not the issue. But the fact is, both of them have had sufficient experience within the House to know the basic tenets of the law and basic positions enunciated by the Constitution. Therefore, Mr. Speaker, putting those matters in the right perspective, I urge you to act according to your conscience in resolving this unnecessary confrontation that has arisen because of this illegal, unconstitutional actions that have taken place by certain bearers of constitutional office. Thank you.